I guess an artist, I have the luxury of picking the content that I want to paint, like whether it be for profit or for pleasure. I think the passion that I put on canvas, people can feel. People gravitate toward it. It speaks to them. The fun part is getting color on it. It's like looking at the clouds and finding shape. If I weren't painting every day, I honestly don't know what I'd be doing with my life. I mean, it found me. And it's nice to be able to grow and have people grow with you in your process. It's a skill. And to be able to use your brain and your heart and your hands in fluid motion, I find the color creates the subject, opposed to the other way around. I never go in with the intention of creating something or ending something. It just happens. I don't want to dwell on our past as Indian people. I think the future is way brighter and way more important, but you have to acknowledge the work and the fortitude that our ancestors had to keep us here. Like, there's no reason for us to be here at all. None. I think Native artists are by far the purest form of who we are culturally. What we learn and what we teach our children is the purest form of storytelling by Native people. And women, women have had their children ripped away from them, children, their husbands taken away, gone to prison, and women are holding it down. And I think we have done that forever. But empowered Native women artists, they're like unicorns, you know? I mean, when you run into something like that, you know it hits you. It's like running into a wall. They're so forceful, they're so powerful. And to meet someone like that, especially women, you know, they're just so powerful. And you can feel like all of the energy around them is because people want them to succeed. Women are complex creatures to begin with, but there's nothing more beautiful than an empowered Native woman. Sometimes I take it for granted how special it is to be an Indian. There's something very healing about art, and when people get to relate to that part of who I am as like a mom and a wife and a woman, it feels good. The work I produce is what's the aftermath of that incredible moment of being covered in paint and, you know, getting messy and having a good time. And I think that the art is the process of me making it. You get what's left over. It means so much more when the artist has something to say, good, bad, or otherwise. In my art, the dots represent like my children. Like, we're like the stars. I have six, so I'll be here for a long time. And like, the stripes represent humility. And then the star quill, of course, is my grandmother. She was a quilter. The women, of course, my grandma's aunts, mother, sisters, nieces, all of them. I don't paint men that often. I'm a woman, I don't need to paint men. But I do represent men in my buffalo and my horse pieces. So they are there, but not very often. I like seeing women looking grand, looking like royalty. And nothing is sacred. You can always paint over it, always. And there are no mistakes. When you're face to face with any decision you make is right, it's very cool.